pledge allegiance. Brothers and sisters and friends, as is customary in your own tradition, let us now together take on posture and attitude of prayer. Let's pray. Alpha and Omega God, God who is our mother and father, God of new things in every nation, tribe and tongue, God of north, south, east and west, God of the Jew and the Greek, free and the slave, male and female, native born and the alien. As we gather here at the Stroh Center in the beautiful city of Bowling Green, Ohio, we ask for special favor upon those who make their living under this roof, vendors and custodians, management, and all those who labor here, in the hope of receiving a fair wage for an honest day's work. And Holy One, we are full of gratitude, thanking you for the manifold blessings of our lives, our communities, our cities, the state, our nation. We praise you that yours is a love that knows no boundary, no barrier of ethnicity, economic status, educational background, or even political ideology. May we always strive to exhibit that same inclusive love. We pray for your guidance and protection for our nation and those who govern it. As we do so, we pray in a special way for our President, Barack Obama, not only as a leader of this nation, but moreover, as a husband and father. We ask that you would give him wisdom and strength of every kind, spiritually, mentally, physically, that he and those who serve alongside him might be fully equipped to stand in the gap on behalf of the voiceless, that they might manifest the biblical mandate to care for the poor, the widow, and the orphan. God, even as we ask for providence in these worldly matters, we will not accurately reflect your heart if we fail to pray for the President's heart, the health of his marriage, and his relationship with his daughters, so that this man in all his ways be a man after your own heart. And Lord, we would be remiss if we did not confess our own error and brokenness as we struggle to live out your call on us to be people of peace and unity. So we embrace Jesus' words, that blessed are the peacemaker. May we not just cry, peace, peace, but may we also do the things that make for peace. Now we affirm your love, your grace, kindness, and power as we move onward this day, moving forward every day, hoping in all your ways to bring glory and honor to you. Finally, Lord, we give you thanks that so many of our military are returning home safely. You blessed us with this day and with the air we breathe, and now we come before you in the name and authority granted to all the followers of Christ Jesus, even as others approach you under different names, saying that ours is a God of justice and peace for all people. Loved ones together, let the whole assembly say, Amen.
What's so bright? welcome to the stage of Army for America field organizer, Rachel Bowman.
Election day is 40 days away, but we we can't wait to have our voices heard. And here in Ohio, we don't have to. We can start voting